They started talking about the Christian dominance, enlightenment, scientific revolutions. All this was happening, you know. So you did have Herodotus, you did have Pythagoras, you did have, you know, the writings of Aristotle. By the 14th century itself, you will see that philosophers were started asking that what should be the structure of a society. Okay, so definitely feudalism was there, but it was also having some sort of issues, problems. I mean, see, trading was the main important factor by the time it had happened. Okay, and there were lot many issues and the problems society were facing. So that point of time, intellectuals, UPSC did ask also question very, like, you know, several times, how intellectual ideas paved for the emergence of sociology. Now, during 14th century or during Renaissance phase, the intellectuals started questioning and wanted to know or explore that what should be the solutions to this problem. So what they have done, they started looking back in their past, in their history. In this, they have started highlighting that what their earlier people or the ancestor have contributed. So they started reviving their past. Okay, so they started reviving their past by reading different classical texts, art, literature, and finally they concluded that it should be humanistic values which should govern the society. It should not be power or religion which has no scientific tempo. So Renaissance philosophers definitely put lot of importance on having reasons, but at that point of time they were not radical. They were soft, romantic. Like you will see how Leonardo da Vinci is making the pictures and explaining that how, you know, we should have a secular idea. And there are lot many philosophers. Okay, so what you will see, Renaissance is a rebirth of a culture, art, writing, music. Reformation was happening. They started talking about the Christian dominance, enlightenment, scientific revolutions. All this was happening, you know. So you did have Herodotus, you did have Pythagoras, you did have, you know, the writings of Aristotle and Socrates, Plato. These were the people. So that Renaissance was the time of philosophers. Okay, now after Renaissance, you will see that the later second phase we can talk about as Enlightenment. Now during this phase, during Enlightenment, what was happening? During Enlightenment, people become, philosophers become radical. They have started saying, and it is a period of 16th to 17th century. Now the philosophers have started contributing and writing that it should be science and reasons and nothing else should govern the society. During Renaissance phase, people were exploring. But during Renaissance, after this Enlightenment phase, people have got enriched ideas, like we have Locke, Hobbes, who are talking about social contract theory. We have Montesquieu, you know. So we did have philosophers who were talking about human rights. Okay, they are talking about that how individuals, humans, doesn't matter in which class he or she, like, you know, born into, they have some rights. This led to further political revolutions like American Revolution, French Revolutions. So these all are the historical evidence, right? And then we know about Industrial Revolution. All these phases are historical and this gradually led to the changes in society. Now during Industrial Revolution, during 18th, 19th century, what had happened? Industrial Revolution and colonization. Now this was a period when sociology emerged. We did have American Revolution, we did have French Revolution, right? Lot many things were happening here. People have started talking about liberty, fraternity, equality, and Industrial Revolution were just bringing a rapid changes in the structures of society. Now, at this stage, you know, during mid-18th century, society was completely in chaos. It was not at all that earlier changes were not there, but the changes were gradual. But because of scientific discoveries and because of, you know, enhanced rapid developments in communication and technologies, the changes which were coming, it was very speedy in pace. And everything was changing. Very first time, world witnessed something called slum developments. Migration started happening. People have started leaving their families into villages and then working in the factories in town. And lot many health diseases. So poverty become a major problem. And lot many other problems. Now all these forced intellectuals of modern phase, you will say. Modernity, you can say, is generally we understand by various concepts, but modernity we talk about. So it was a period by 18th to 19th century in sociology we understand, for the sake of understanding. Modernity has a lot of discussion. It's a phases, right? It's a new development. Now, all these changes led thinkers to believe that we need a discipline which can talk about practical issues of humans, which can also critically understand what had happened, which will not take anything as it is given to them. They will question it and try to analyze society with scientific temper. This actually was the major reason people thought, philosopher thought, that we do have to develop our discipline, right? So during 17th century, Auguste Comte, Saint-Simon, and then you know that how Karl Marx writing has a major influences in sociology, Emil Durkheim, we do have George, like, you know, many thinkers, George Simmel, all these thinkers are trying to understand what we can contribute by creating a new discipline, which other previously existing discipline could not do, such as philosophy, history, or any other discipline. Okay? So sociology did emerge because of all these historical factors which I just discussed. Okay.